As we saw in the previous lesson, inheritance is a mechanism for sharing implementation. I define implementation as either a variable or a method including the method body. We also saw that inheritance is a weak mechanism for abstraction. Conversely, interfaces are a weak mechanism for sharing implementation, but a strong mechanism for abstraction. In this video, we will further explore these ideas of weak and strong mechanisms and get into a practical example of interfaces, which will be common for anyone building GUI applications on desktop, mobile, and web. The first principle to understand about interfaces is that they allow us to share what I will call behavior among classes. Now, in the context of programming, I mean something very specific when I say behavior. I define behavior strictly as meaning that we are sharing all parts of a method except the method body. If we were sharing the method body, that would be sharing implementation. Until you look at a practical example, this can seem like a rather pointless thing to do. Is it not just creating extra work that we have to do later? We will see soon enough. Interfaces, as discussed before, are essentially just classes which allow methods to be defined but not implemented. We call these unimplemented methods abstract methods. Now, for technical accuracy, there is actually a feature of interfaces which allows fully implemented methods to be written, and this feature is called a default method. I will not go into detail on them as they are designed to help in maintaining old code bases, which does not concern us, and their existence confuses the original purpose of an interface. Here we have an interface called IEventHandler, which defines an abstract method called handle. We can add as many abstract methods as we want, but just one should suffice for now. You may have noticed that we have some angle brackets here with a T between them. You may also notice this T showing up in our handle method. This is what is known as a generic type. Essentially, what we are saying is that we want whatever class which implements this interface and its functions to decide what type will be used. Now, I could actually use whatever name I want here as long as it is not a reserved keyword like new or void. However, if I pick a name like event, we will very likely have conflicts with other types that are either defined within this project or the libraries which this project uses. Therefore, by convention, we usually use a single capital letter, such as T for type. Now we will look at implementing an interface. Go ahead and open up Interfaces in Practice Starter.java in Part 4, Lesson 3 of the demo source code. We will be making our EventHandlerImple class implement the IEventHandler interface. Now, I have created an enum here to represent different events one might expect from a desktop system. Obviously, it is just for demonstration purposes, but I do actually like to use enums for this purpose, assuming there is not an extraordinarily large number of elements required for the enum. The way in which you make a class implement an interface is via the implements keyword. Because we also specified that this interface expects some generic type to be defined in the class which implements it, we must do that here. As you can probably guess, we will use our event enum. My IDE is now complaining that I have not actually implemented the abstract methods defined in the interface. I could manually type it out, but instead I will click on the red underlined text, hit Alt-Enter, and select Implement Methods. In order to avoid confusion, anytime we implement an abstract method, we must include this special annotation @overrides. This will tell the compiler and IDE where to find the implementation of the abstract method, and it also tells us that this method comes from an interface or abstract class. As a bonus tip, enums like this work great with switch statements. We have seen how interfaces are built and how they work with classes using the implements keyword. However, the most important piece of this puzzle is being able to identify situations where an interface is useful. In the demo Sudoku application, I've written a class which does the work of building the user interfaces and listening for different events which represent the ways in which the user can interact with the application. This is a side note, but an important feature of interfaces is that we can implement as many interfaces as we want, but we can only extend from one single parent class. Java does not allow multiple inheritances. Anyways, in order for this class, User Interface Simple to receive events from the operating system about when a user interacts with the application, I have implemented the Event Handler interface. Unlike the one we saw previously, this interface is actually defined in the JavaFX library, which is a core Java library for building user interfaces. So here is a primary case. We need a way for the JavaFX code to send messages to this class which I wrote. I achieve that by making this class implement the Event Handler interface and registering that interface with every part of the application which the user can manipulate. For example, in this app, I build a text field for every square in the Sudoku puzzle. In order to get this User Interface class to be wired up to every different text field, I add this User Interface Simple class to every text field by using the setOnKeyPressed method. Notice how when I click between the argument brackets of this method, it tells me that it requires an event handler. Well, remember, this refers to User Interface Simple, and User Interface Simple implements event handler. Just to really hit home this point about weak and strong mechanisms for abstraction, it is worth pointing out a key feature of interfaces. Unlike classical inheritance, and the other topic we will look at next, abstract classes, interfaces allow us to share behavior among classes that do not need to be within the same class hierarchy. Further, what if I decided to build a second user interface screen of my Sudoku app, which displays user statistics like how many games they have won, lost, and various other records? In this case, this other statistics user interface simple will necessarily need to share the behavior of being an event handler, but it will also need to implement that behavior in a different way. In short, less sharing is more abstract and more sharing is less abstract. One final note. Interfaces have very important uses in software architecture, which we will discuss in Part 5.